We are in the front of the Red Pyramid in Dachau. Officially, according to Egyptologists, this is the third pyramid built by the first pharaoh of the four dynasties, Nefer. And this is, according to them, his resting place. However, no mummy has been discovered here, nor other traces that would direct us towards the fourth dynasty or any known dynasty whatsoever. At the same time, this is my favorite pyramid. The reason why is one thing which will sound like a blasphemy to the Egyptologists. The reason why? According to me, this is the oldest pyramid on Egyptian soil. If we agree to the scenario that more advanced beings came to Egypt 36,000 years ago, as Turin King List indicates, I think this was the first pyramid, and the reason for that, the degree of the erosion on the blocks is among the biggest, if not the biggest. The blocks behind us are red limestone. That's the reason why the pyramid is called Red Pyramid, because during the sunset we can see this reddish color of the whole pyramid. But you see, red limestone, rather hard material, is turning to the dust.
Yeah.
Not after a few thousand years, but after tens of thousands of years. This pyramid is huge in size. As far as the height, it is the third highest pyramid on Egyptian soil, only after the Cheops and Khafres. Number 3 and number 4, those positions are shared by the Red and Bent Pyramid. But as far as the surface, this is the second largest. The length at the base of more than 220 meters. The angle is 43 degrees. Inside we will find 3 chambers. How many more? We do not know. But as you will see, they are perfectly done with the corbel roof, which reminds us a lot of the Mayan architecture. That's what they were using when they wanted to build a ceiling without use of mortar or cement. This pyramid has a perfect orientation. According to my NEV camera, New Energy Vision camera, this one is energetically calm, energetically dead, so it does not function as the energy machine no more. During my meditation, last time when I was here, I got this information that this one was done first. And the knowledge that came with those who migrated here was used first here, and then in the case of other pyramids. And then they were experimenting, first with the different slopes, and then making more huge pyramid complexes like a Giza complex, when they were using the power of the energy movement in between the pyramids. So it's a shame that we don't apply our engineering knowledge and geophysical knowledge on these pyramids in Egypt. And as we could see, the whole Egyptian landscape is dotted in pyramids. This knowledge today is unfortunately dead in front of us. So my message is always, why don't we use our short lifespans trying to understand the ancient builders, get to some of their knowledge and apply it in our society to solve our problems, starting with the energy, free and clean energy, to all others.